where you are going, you can sing and shout and dance and celebrate with that song. Amen. This world is not our home. Amen. We're just a passing through, the songwriter says. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. I greet you as I always do in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Savior, to whom belongs honor and glory, dominion and power forever and forever. One more hand clap for this great Jesus, Savior, Savior of our soul. We slept in that room, we cooked in that room. three sons and her granddaughter, who was my age that she was raising at that time. And God has blessed each and every one of us, and we have accomplished great things in our lives. But that's where God brought me from. So excuse me if I'm a little bit overly excited this Thanksgiving, as I remember where God has brought me from. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. This morning, however, I want to use the time that I have here to bring you back to your Thanksgiving table. Amen. The home or the place where you celebrated Thanksgiving this past Thursday. I know the food was good. Some of you have a smile on your face as I said I'm bringing you back to the table. Amen. I was blessed to celebrate my Thanksgiving with two families. The fellowship was good, and the food was good in both homes. Amen? Excellent food. Hallelujah. And so I trust that each and every one of you, that you had a happy Thanksgiving. Praise the Lord. Now, I was not at your table. I was not at your table, but I know without a doubt that there was some good conversation at the table. Come on, raise your hand. There was some good conversation. Only one person had a good conversation. This is Thanksgiving. Everybody's mouth is just, come on now. Hallelujah. Maybe some of you were watching sports during Thanksgiving. Let me see your hand. Were you watching the ball game? Oh, yeah, we have a few. Were you watching a ball game? Come on now. Yes, a few of you were watching the ball game. Amen. But at the table, I could hear somebody say, please pass the turkey. Was that you? Was that you? Do we have anybody here who, you know, you wanted some more turkey and, you know, while the conversation was going on, you're like, please pass the turkey. Amen. Or somebody said, please pass the stuffing. Amen. Yeah, we have a hand in the back. Who said, please pass the ham? Let me see your hand. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, please pass the ham. We have one hand in the back. How about please pass the roast beef? Let me see. Anybody have roast beef for Thanksgiving? Huh? Oh, we have one. I know we got to have one. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, everybody's hand should be going up now. Please pass the gravy. Come on, let me see your hand. Nobody had beside that gravy? Oh, nobody but over here. Yeah, they love their gravy. Hallelujah. I'm going to get to your table. How about please pass the curry chicken? Come on now. Come on. Nobody has curry chicken on this side? We have one in the back. Yes, I know there's somebody over there. Was there any jerk chicken? Please pass the jerk chicken. Yeah, oh man. See that? We're getting right. I see right at your table. Amen. Please pass the oxtail. Come on. Push that hand up, Brother Wendell. Yeah, please pass. Oh, yeah. Katrina, our town councilor, please pass the oxtail. Amen. How about please pass the rose? Come on now. Am I the only one who like bread? Please pass the bread. No bread? I wonder what some of you have. Some hands haven't gone up yet. Oh, you were at work. Amen. How about please pass the rice? Yeah, we kind of get there. Amen. Now, please pass the wine. Yeah, we got a few. Please pass. Oh, yeah. A few who say please pass the wine. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. How about please pass the punch? Or the tea or the coffee? Come on. Let me see your hand. Amen. Any champagne? We got a couple in there. Yeah, please pass the champagne. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, I want to share with you, and I hope someone said these words and made this request at your table. Amen. says, please, there's a child reaching out, and mommy is pouring water at the table for that little girl. You see, as I said to you last week, water is very important to a person's health and to the continuation of your life. May I encourage you this Thanksgiving to drink more water. Amen? Drink more water. I have been practicing that. Amen? You see, the reason is our body, like I told you last week, and anyone who studies human biology will tell you that the human body is comprised of mostly water, 63% water. The brain and the heart, 73% water. The lung is composed of 83% water. Even your muscles is mostly made up of water. Why am I saying that? Because these organs are made up primarily of water, they need water to function. Amen? They need water to function. They say that a person can survive for 3 weeks without food, but you will only last 3 days without water. Lack of water can cause you to feel dehydrated, meaning weak and fatigued. Some folks have severe headaches simply because they don't have enough intake of water. Amen? If you go for a long period, excessive length of time without water, I have discovered in my research that your brain will begin to shrink. Amen? So I'm sharing this message with you, not only in a physical context, but in a spiritual context. Please pass the water. Amen? Now, as water revitalized the body, remember last week I shared with you from Psalm 42, 1 through 2. David says, as the deer panteth for the water brook, so my soul longeth after you. And I shared how the deer was being chased by wild dogs in the wilderness of Palestine. And the deer was running, but the deer was weak. And the deer panted for the water brook. And so David, he was being chased by his son Absalom, wanted to kill him. And he was chased out of Jerusalem, and his soul longed to worship God. And he equated this longing that he had to worship God with the deer panting for the water brook. He says, as the deer pants for the water, so my soul longed for you, O God, for the true and the living God. Amen? So as water revitalizes you physically, so too does water. The symbolism of water, or living water, as we're going to read about in our text for today, coming from John chapter 4, 1 through 15. Amen. Spiritual water, which is the Holy Spirit, revitalizes us spiritually. Amen. The Bible calls it living water. Amen. So I want you to stand and let's read our scripture for today, coming to us from John chapter 4, 1 through 15. Amen. Many of you know the story. Please stand. Please stand in honor of God's word. Many of you know the story. And oftentimes people read the story, they begin to, some will even condemn the woman. Amen. The woman who was a prostitute. But I don't want you to condemn her today. I want you to see the similarity in your life between you and this woman in a spiritual context. Amen? Because when we exchange the things of God for the things of the world, we are like spiritual prostitutes. students are not just women, like it used to be. You have men who are prostitutes. So we're not doing the gender thing this morning, isolation thing. Amen? So kind of see yourself. Have a little bit of self-reflection this morning. Hallelujah. Amen? What is it you are exchanging your soul for? Jesus says in Matthew chapter 16, I think it's verse 26, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? And then he says, what can you give in exchange for your soul? And so this woman was giving away her body for money. And Jesus ministered to her like he wants to minister to you this morning. What are you giving in exchange for your own soul? Hallelujah. So can we read aloud? Amen. When therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, though Jesus himself baptized not but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again into Galilee. And he must needs go through Samaria. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near to the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being weary with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou being a Jew askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that said to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof of himself, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up unto everlasting life. The woman said unto him, sir, give me this drink, that I thirst not, neither cometh hither to draw. In other words, the woman said maybe what you said at the Thanksgiving table, or someone said, please pass the water. Can we pray? Eternal God, thou heavenly Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise, we honor you and we glorify you. We thank you for this moment when your word becomes alive in our lives. When your word becomes applicable to our lives, we pray, God, that we will receive your word today that will help to transform our lives and make us more like your son, Jesus. May the very words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O God, my strength and my redeemer, in whose name I pray. Amen. Praise God. You may be seated. You may be seated. Hallelujah. And, the word is rich here, isn't it? Isn't it good? Isn't it good to just read the word of God and conceptualize it and understand it and see yourself in the word? Amen. Well, in the passage we read, we find Jesus in Samaria, a city he had come to on his way from Judea in the south that particular time.
Amen.
You know, when you have a neighbor you don't get along with, and you don't go to that side of the house. Amen. Come on now. Or it's somebody on the street that you just can't get along with, and you go around to get where you're going. Sometimes instead of driving up the street, which is shorter, you go down the street and around the block because you don't feel like talking to that neighbor. You don't even want to see him. Amen. I know it's true. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So it was. The Judean Jews would go all the way around Samaria, at times even into Jordan, to get to Galilee, because they had this rift with the Samaritans. Amen? And they segregated themselves from the Samaritans. And we understand segregation. We live in a nation that still practices, where some folks still practice segregation, and it hurts. Amen? And so Jesus, a Judean Jew, the Bible said that he went from Judea, amen, up to Samaria. Before we get there, in verse 1, it says, when therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, amen, then he left Judea to go to Galilee. Amen? So the Pharisees, they were trying to stir up some issues with Jesus over people getting saved. Amen? And it's amazing how you'd be doing something good and yet people are still jealous of you. In some cases, you're trying to help them. And it's amazing, even with our own, some folks will take help from certain people who look different from them than receive help from you who is certified and capable of providing them with that help. It's just human nature. It's just how messed up we are. Yeah. Jesus was, you know, people were coming to him. They were getting baptized. And let me just say, to be a true disciple of Jesus Christ, it requires first you accept him as Savior. Yes. And then you get baptized.
Amen.
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 I'm praying that you will say, Pastor, I want to get baptized. What's your first name again? Leah. Amen. You did the first step this morning, was to receive Jesus. There's another step, is to get baptized.
Amen.
This is what publicly identifies you as a follower of Jesus. Amen. And every religion, you know, and groups, even social groups, in colleges, you'd be amazed to know what people have to do, sororities and all of that, to get in, to be a Christian. As Jesus was baptized, so too we get baptized. And again, I'm saying and I'm extending an invitation, if you have not yet been baptized, let us do that for you on New Year's Eve.
Amen.
God is saying, stop putting it off. Amen. If you say that you are a follower of Christ, that you believe in Jesus, and he's your Lord and your Savior, there's a next step to that, and that is to get baptized. Don't let the devil tell you it's not necessary. Don't let the devil tell you that you're going to be, you know, embarrassed. It's embarrassing. Amen. I'd rather be embarrassed for Jesus, say amen, somebody, than accepted by the world.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap. Hallelujah. So Jesus, on his way, in verse 4, the Bible says, he must need go through Samaria. Did you get it? Samaria, where the Judean Jews didn't go, Jesus had this urgency to go through Samaria. Amen. grace today. Anything that's necessary to get you saved, the Lord will do it. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap today. Amen. You know, for Leah who gets saved this morning, God had to bring you into a new home. Am I right? Had to bring you into a new home, into a church you had never been before, so that Jesus can reach you, so that you can hear the call of God on your life in a way that you can understand, and it became personal to you, and that's why you responded. No one else but you, because that call was for you. I didn't know. God just laid on my heart to make an appeal. This is the day of salvation for someone. And you responded. Amen. He will go through. He will arrange your life in such a way that you come face to face with him. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap in this place here today. Hallelujah. And so it was with this woman of Samaria. Amen. And let me just say to you, be prepared to go through some difficulties if you really want to win that family member to the Lord. You want to win your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, your son, your daughter. Be prepared to go through some difficulties, to do something maybe you have never done before in order to win them. Let me tell you, winning souls is not easy. Are you with me? The devil will create such a ruckus. Listen, he doesn't let unsaved people go that easily. And in order to win them to Jesus, you're going to have to do something maybe beyond yourself. You may have to speak like you have never spoken to before. You may have to pray like you have never prayed before. You may have to stand up when others are sitting down. Hallelujah. Just to win a soul. On the job, you may have to be a witness. You may have to conduct yourself in such a way different from the crowd so that people can see Christ in you, the hope of glory. Come on, let's give the Lord a mighty hand clap. Amen. So God said he had need to go through Samaria. Hallelujah. The Samaritans and the Judean Jews, they just didn't get along. Something happened way back. When the Assyrians conquered the northern kingdom, Israel, and the Israelites of the northern kingdom were taken captive, amen, many of them intermarried with groups of people who made up the Assyrian kingdom, like the Syrians. And because of that, the Jews in Judea who felt themselves pure had nothing to do with them. Amen? And let me tell you, religion can divide you. You'd be amazed to know how many divisions we have in the kingdom of God. Amen. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen? Deep-rooted things. Even folks coming to Christ sometimes, they have some tradition. They will not part with it.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
All because of what religion taught them. Religion does not save anybody.
Amen.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Rituals don't save you. Christ wants a relationship with you. The end of religion.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. I'm a Baptist. I'm a Catholic. I'm a Lutheran. Listen, we're a non-denominational church here at Spring of Water. Whosoever will, come on, help me, somebody. Let them come. Let them come. Praise the name of the Lord. Whether you have your hair braided or you wear an extension, get looking people's business here. Amen. Say, don't go there, Pastor. Don't go there, Pastor. Amen. But it doesn't matter. Amen. You're free to put yourself together. Hallelujah. As long as you're decent and in order. Let's give the Lord a mighty hand clap in this place here today. Hallelujah. Praise God. One day I'm going to preach in some jeans. Do you think that will ever happen? Amen, 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 amen. But Jesus had need to go to Samaria because he wanted to demonstrate the Lord a hand clap. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We're all one in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So the picture here, follow it now, it's playing out before you. Jesus is sitting by a well, and he's awaiting this woman. So I want you to know, when I say awaiting, Jesus was not there by accident.
No.
Say amen to somebody.
Yes.
He had an appointed time.
Yes.
With this woman.
Yes.
Praise the name of
yes.
the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes. And I'm saying that to let you know that God has an appointed time for each and every one of us.
Amen.
The Bible says it's appointed to every man once to die, and after death comes the judgment. God has an appointed time. Hallelujah. I'm so glad I didn't miss my appointed time when Jesus came my way. Hallelujah. I was age 14 when I gave my life to Jesus Christ. Didn't start serving him fully. Didn't get into the ministry. Hallelujah. Until maybe some 20 years or so later. But I thank God, hallelujah, that Jesus had me on his mind and he kept that appointment. Hallelujah. Sometimes I didn't keep my appointment and you won't keep yours, but Jesus will wait on you. Say amen, somebody. One song might have put it this way, says softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling for you and for me. See over the portals, he's waiting and watching for you and for me. Listen, Jesus will wait you out. I say to you, don't keep him waiting for you forever. He will not wait on you forever. Hallelujah. But he's a patient God. Say amen, somebody. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If God waited on you, why don't you give him a hand clap in this place here today? He called you not only once, he called you twice. Some of you three times, four times, he waited on you. Hallelujah. The message is, please pass the water. Amen. So Jesus catches the picture now. Jesus is sitting on the wall, waiting on this woman. Amen. The place was called Jacob's Well. It was that parcel of land that Jacob gave to his son Joseph and to their descendants. So it had a lot of history to it, a lot of connection to it, and you know what? They considered that land so sacred. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen? But Jesus went there because he had an appointment with this woman. And so verse 7 says, there cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink. Amen? Give me to drink. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen? So that makes Jesus a beggar. Can you imagine that? Jesus is the source of life. Amen? Jesus is the water that was not in the well. Say amen, somebody. Jesus, you know, he says, I am the living water. But yet, still, Jesus, the source of living water, what is he doing? Begging for a drink of water. Let's pause there for a little while. Amen? So I can share with you that, you know what? Jesus humbled himself. He became a beggar for this woman just so that she could drink of that water that she would never, ever thirst again. When you couldn't draw water and you're going to find out, the woman says, you know, what are you going to draw water with? Jesus didn't even have a cup to draw water. Amen? That means that he was so poor, he didn't even have a utensil Jesus, hallelujah, immortal, invisible, God only wise, became a man just so that you can understand how God loves you and how God cares for you and how God wants to have a relationship with you. Christ came and died that you may have life and life more abundantly. He gave up his life that you may have life. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap in this place. You'll be amazed to know. Philippians 2:8 says, and being found in the fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself. I'm repeating myself. Amen. He humbled himself. 2 Corinthians 5:21, Paul puts this transformation or this humbling of Jesus. He says, for he had made him to be sin for us, the righteous Son of God. Do you get it? He became sin for us. He who knew no sin became sin for us, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Can't you see the extent to which Jesus went? Just to save you. Yeah, won't you give him a hand clap in this place here today? But the woman couldn't understand this. She was just so caught up on religion that instead of receiving Christ, amen, she got into a debate. She got into some kind of discourse. Verse 9 says, then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou being a Jew ask a drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritan. Amen? So she went into this segregation thing. I don't understand. You're from Judea, you won't ask of me? A Samaritan for a drink of water? That doesn't make sense. Listen. There are some things that doesn't make sense, but it's still necessary for you to come to Jesus.
Amen.
Did you get that?
Amen.
It doesn't make sense how God would come down and offer up himself, be mocked and scourged and beaten and whipped. It doesn't make sense. He's God. The Bible said he could call down 10,000 angels. But because of you, because of the need to save you, hallelujah, he offered up himself. We don't understand these things. And don't try to understand the infinite wisdom of God with your finite mind. Stop debating. Stop searching. You know, this person and that person, and you want to Google salvation. No, you don't have to Google salvation. Just receive salvation. Google doesn't save you. Google may give you the meaning of salvation, but knowing the meaning of salvation does not save you. You get saved when you receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and you understand how he gave up himself just for you. He who knew no sin became sin for you.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's give him a hand clap. See, when you understand that, you will give your life to Jesus Christ. But if you're waiting for Google to answer it for you, ma'am, waiting for Google to explain it for you, it doesn't work that way. Google needs to be saved. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So, you know, she just wanted a dialogue. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. She had all the questions. Verse 10 said, Jesus answered. Not the way she wanted. Go with me now to Genesis, and go with me to Leviticus, and let's look at the 12 sons of Jacob, and who was king in down in Egypt during the time of Moses. And it's good to know that information, but let me tell you, those information still doesn't save you. Don't think you can know everything in the Bible. Some folks will give their life to Jesus when they know everything. path in the Word of God. Your pastor understands very little. And I'm not going to try to pretend as if I'm, you know, even though I've graduated the seminary, as if I know it all. No. You could be sitting there and know more than me. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. The important thing is you answer his call. That when he calls you, you answer him. That when he sends you, you say, yes, Lord, send me. Come on, let's give him a hand clap. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So Jesus answered and said unto her, would you put that up? John 4:10. If thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. See, some folks are not saved because they don't understand the precious gift of salvation. They don't understand what God did for them. They don't understand John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave, listen, his only begotten son. He gave his only begotten son. He gave the best gift that you could ever have, his son, that what? Whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. When you understand how God gave his son, you will understand it's the greatest gift of all. The gift of God's Son to you, to save you, is the greatest gift of all. Put your hands together and tell the Lord, thank you. You have something to thank God for this Thanksgiving. If you have Jesus, you have the greatest gift of all. You may not get a gift for Christmas, but don't be disappointed. You have the greatest gift of all if you have Jesus. Oh, come on, give him a mighty shout up in this house today. He says, if you knew the gift, and I'm saying to those of you who are sitting here today, and you have not yet given your life to Jesus, not gone through the waters of baptism like he demonstrated for us, you really don't know the gift of God. You really don't know the cost, what the price that was paid for you even to be sitting in this church today. God laid on my heart to come to Randolph and to start this ministry. And now we have our own building. Listen, sir. Listen, ma'am. It's not me. I have very little to do with that. You are here today by the grace of God. This church is a gift to you. This church, this ministry is a gift to you. Come on, tell the Lord, thank you. If only you knew the gift. If only you knew what it took to get here and the coming together of people and the giving. Some have given out of what they don't have so you can have a church to worship in. Given their all. When there's a call to give, when there's a call to build a school, they're the first to give.
Amen.
And you don't understand the gift that you have. The wonderful chair you're sitting in, the lights in this place, the word that you're receiving, the pastor preaching to you, it's a gift from God. Don't take it for granted. Little girl, when I feel like no, if you understand the precious gift that God has given you, you'll be right here to worship the Lord. You'll be in the prayer meeting. You'll be in Sunday school. Say amen to somebody. It's all a gift from God, but we have this habit, especially in our culture, we take everything for granted. We are enabled. We make no sacrifices. We give nothing, but we want everything.
Amen.
If you understand the gift of God, you will worship God differently.
Yes.
You will relate to your brothers and sisters differently. Yes. Some of the little things that divide us, you get rid of it.
Amen. Amen.
Woman didn't realize she was. She went the Jesus we serve here today, Springwater? Do you know the price that was paid for you to sit here? What God offered up for you to sit here and to hear his word? Praise God. And it's not until we come to the realization of God's gift and the price that God paid to win us back and to save our soul. Until then, your attitude will never change. Your behavior will never change. No matter what is said or what is done, until you understand the gift that God freely gave to you. Speaking about gifts, understand also the men and women who have given up themselves and sacrificed themselves that you are free. You can live where you are and go to the school that you're going to and the college that your children are going to. Others paved the way, but we're a society. We don't understand the price that was paid for the freedom that we have. Do you understand the gift of God? Verse 11 says, the woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw. She just quickly changed the subject. And some folks are changing the subject even while I'm preaching. Yeah, you're at the mall. You're thinking about the leftovers from Thanksgiving. You're ready to switch the subject. You're ready for the end. But when you understand the gift, you will want more. Say amen, somebody. So she went on rambling. Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with. Lady, he owns the well. A cattle on 1,000 hills belong to him. He is the source of life. He is the living water, lady. Don't you get it? Amen. Says if you know the gift, you would ask of him, and he would give you living water, lady. Don't you realize? He is the living water. He is the source of life. Don't you get it? That lady, you came for water, but you're thirsty. Don't you realize that the water that he gives, that lady, that you'll never thirst again? Amen. Enough of the questions. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. I just want to know about the brook and the piece of land. Who owns it? Who cares, lady? Receive the gift of God. Receive your salvation. Receive the living water. So Jesus, you know what? He didn't even address that. I love Jesus. So now we're talking all kind of Jesus. And you know what? He's not even paying attention to that. He's touching your heart in another way. You want, please God, give me this gift. And he's like, no, I want to save you. I want to turn your life around. I want to break that habit in your life. You want a new house? You want a new car? You're only going to crash that car if you keep on vaping and keep on smoking and drinking. He gets to your problems. He fixes what needs fixing. Sometimes you want God to fix what you want him to fix. No, he fixes what needs fixing. Come on, give him a hand clap. That was on me. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So Jesus answered and said unto her, whoso drinketh of this water shall thirst again. Amen. You keep vaping to satisfy your thirst. You're going to keep on vaping. You're smoking crack. They say, right? Crack. I want to really get to the crack smokers. I know we don't have any here. Thank God for that. But there's going to be some listening by way of radio, by way of the CD and on YouTube. Amen? So you're using crack to satisfy your thirst. Without the living water, you're going to keep wanting more crack. You're going to keep wanting more marijuana. Whatever it is you're using to satisfy the thirst for God, you're going to keep you're going to shop till you drop. If it's working, you're going to work 36 hours in a 24-hour day. Do the math. Amen. But some folks, it's like 36 hours. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. If it's about the material, you're going to keep seeking it. Some are using sex and pornography to satisfy the thirst of their soul. Listen, when God formed man from the dust of the earth, he breathed into man the breath of life. Man became a living soul. From that moment on, your soul longed for the living God.
Amen.
And nothing else will do. Drink all the rum you want, sir. You're just going to keep on drinking rum. For it will never satisfy your thirst. So we're going to wrap it up. Won't you stand? Hallelujah. And can you put verse 13 up on the overhead? And let's read that together as we close. Amen. Let's read aloud. Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. You got it? See, the water in the well, you drink all of it, you will still thirst. Amen? What you need, lady, is living water. Come on, read with me. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up to everlasting life. Did you hear that? Living water is what we need to satisfy our thirst. Amen. The you know, water in a cup is really dead water. Did you know that? But water coming out of a spring is living water. That's why this church is spring of water.
Amen.
That means the water just keep bubbling and bubbling and bubbling. And your life just keep changing and changing and changing. When you drink of that living water, it's an active water. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. So he says, whosoever drink of that water shall never thirst. The water I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. In other words, he's going to pour out his Holy Spirit. Say amen. Living water is the Spirit of God. On that day I will pour out my Spirit, saith the Lord. Your young men shall prophesy, your old men shall dream. The Bible records for us in Acts chapter 2, on the day of Pentecost, there was a pouring out of that living water. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost came down like cloven tongues of fire, and it landed upon each of them. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And they all spoke with a new tongue. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. They spoke in a language they had never spoken before. See, when the Holy Ghost comes, when the living water comes inside of you, you begin to do extraordinary things. Things that you have never done before. Listen, when the living water gets inside of you, you were weak, now you are made strong. Say amen, somebody. The poor man now declares that I am rich. I'm talking about the living water. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Life has changed when you allow the living waters to flow. I want somebody to sing for us, let your living water flow over my soul. Somebody just cue that up for us. Get the microphone, cue it up if you can. Somebody knows it. Praise the name of the Lord. But you know what? We need that living water. Would you bring this water here, brother? Praise the Lord. Amen. Just before you sing it, here's a verse I want to share with you as I bring this water out. And this water is more for me than for you. Last week, everybody got a bottle of water. And I told you, take that water. what? And when you thirst for God, take a drink. I'm going to give you some water this morning from a cup for those who are thirsty for God.
Amen.
But the reward is for me. Mark 9:41. For whosoever shall give you a cup of water to drink in my name, because you belong to Christ, verily I say unto you, he shall not lose his reward. You may be saying, but Pastor, you gave us water last week. You're going to give us water again? Yes. This one is for me, so that I don't lose my reward. So you are here today. Hallelujah. And you just need a refreshing. You need the Spirit of God to bubble up inside of you. I want to pass you a cup of water today. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So you're thirsty for God. Last week I preached thirsty for God. But you're here today, Pastor, I'm still thirsty. I want more. All you got to do when you come is say, Pastor, please, pass the water. And I'm going to give it to you, and I want to give it to you. We have so many cups here today. I'm going to ask a few. Pastor, won't you come, Sister Joy? You all come and just fill up some water. Would you sing that song for us? We're getting ready. Getting ready to close. Let your living water.
Let your living water. Over my soul, let your Holy Spirit come and take control in every situation that has troubled my soul. All my cares and burdens unto you.
Amen. Pastor, I need a refreshing. Come, come.
Let your name.
Come, all you gotta do is say, please pass the water.
Flow over my soul.
Come, come. Come and watch this living water begin to work in your life.
Come and take
in the name of Jesus Christ. Just say, Pastor, please pass the water. In Jesus' name.
Situation.
I pass you this water today in the name of Jesus.
Oh,
give you insight and capabilities like you've never had before. into another level of faith in your life in the name of Jesus. May your enemy be turned back. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. May the Lord God, no weapons formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rise up against you in judgment shall be condemned. Do not fear those who seek to destroy the body, but fear the one who's able to destroy the soul and the body in the name of Jesus. God says to tell somebody there are more for you than against you. You are not alone. Go forth now in the strength of the Lord. Face him, face her, face that thing in the name of Jesus and conquer it. You have the victory. Christ died that you win. Christ died that you have the victory. Go now and walk in victory in Jesus' name.